Here's what's going on in the New Jersey area supermarkets this month. Hey there, NJ, Route22.com here with another supermarket kind of news chat discussion for the supermarkets in the Northeast, primarily in New Jersey and PA and so on. We got some observations we're going to make this month, and there's no rhyme or reason here, but we do it anyway. Number one is that we started noticing the holiday eggnogs out in full force this month. It was actually back in October, late September. They just bring this stuff out. They got a muscle for shelf space. But you look at the eggnogs, any of them, they're like really high in sugar and we don't touch them. But eggnog is a sign of the times. Also interesting to note is that ShopRite, and like many other supermarkets and other big chain stores, they're venturing out into their own house brand, which means they get some big company to I guess it's called white labeling or something like that, where some other company makes it for them and they put their name and brand on it. They put in fine print it says ShopRite, but the ShopRite has something called Bowl and Basket, and another one that I'm talking about here is this house brand of paper products called Paper Bird or something like that. And they have nice minimalist design. It looks kind of like some sort of, I can't describe it exactly, but we do not vouch for these products. We don't like them. They're fairly high on the price side, and the value is crap because the quality sucks. ShopRite, if you're watching this, improve your product, get a different supplier. They're awful, awful, awful products. I don't like them, especially paper towels. They're rougher than sandpaper. And the next thing I need to point out, I didn't know this my whole life. Campbell's soups, those condensed soups like cream of mushroom, for instance, we were going to make some sort of casserole. And I was ready to buy a can of Campbell's condensed cream of mushroom soup. And I looked at the label, I'm like, MSG, monosodium glutamate, was one of the primary ingredients. I put it down and I found some organic crap on the other side of the aisle. But no wonder everybody used to love these stuffings that they made and all the kinds of casseroles they made with these condensed soups. They're highly addictive. Read the label on these things. You got to watch out. No matter how cheap it is, you're going to shovel it down and get sick and overeat. Don't do it. And my last little tidbit for today is we've been watching the low-carb ice cream trend. There was one like 6 months ago. It was Rebel Ice Cream. It was the only keto, high-fat, zero or very low-sugar, low-carb ice cream, and it was made with one of those natural sweeteners. I think erythritol and monk fruit were the sweeteners. And now the Enlightened brand started coming out with a keto collection version. We tried them, and I should put a little asterisk here, footnote. We think we're on the verge of saying, or have said, that eating anything sweet, even if it's a healthy sweetener, is probably not a good thing because the human body is not meant to eat such quantity of sweets. There was a reason you had to climb a tree to get an orange back in the caveman days, and I don't know. We just don't think so, but that we should be eating it. But there are now like at least half a dozen or more of these low-carb ice creams, and one we picked up a couple pints today is called Sola brand, and that's a massive brand with all sorts of different low sugar or products, breads too. And they want to replace our memories of the standard American diet. And maybe these low carb sugars are good. I don't know. I'm kind of on the fence with this, but I haven't tried these new ice creams yet. Apparently, they're the most like old ice cream of days past. I'll say one thing about these low-carb ice creams, that the texture is not quite the same as regular ice cream. They're either too crystally, because I think xylitol causes some sort of crystallization, ice crystals. It's not as smooth as sugar-based ice creams. But apparently this new one, there's two new sweeteners too. One is allulose, which apparently is really good from some people's perspectives, and another one called Tagatos, which is a dairy-based sweetener that's in these Sola ice creams that we bought. We'll report back at a future time on what these ice creams taste like, and they were actually a good price. They were only like $3 a pint compared to some of the $6, $7 pints that there's a keto brand, which is awful. And you gotta watch out, these new low carb ice creams, they're stepping up the carb count per serving. And that means some of these pints are getting up into 20, 30, 40, 50 grams of carbs levels. Whereas Rebel ice cream only had anywhere between 4 and maybe 7 grams of carbs per pint, which is very low. That means you can shovel the whole pint down and not spike your blood sugar. So that's it for this month's supermarket observations. Open your eyes, look around, walk down aisles you don't normally go, and just see what's going on in the food world. You gotta monitor these things to make sure, especially those plant-based things, you know. But that's it. Hit the subscribe button, like, and all that stuff, and I'll be back next month with another collection of observations. Have a good day.